Hi, welcome to Chris BI. My name is Chris Wagner, and today we're going to be going over the new smart narratives in Power BI, and we're going to be comparing it against the Narrative Sciences Custom Visual. Let's go check it out. But before we do, make sure you go down to hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and even turn on alerts so you get all the latest, greatest features as we release them. It really helps the channel, and I appreciate it. Thank you. All right. So the new smart narratives is an excellent way to enhance an existing report to allow you to provide some additional insights into what's going on inside your narrative, mainly generated through AI, but you have a lot of ability to go in and customize and make some enhancements to it. So I'm going to do some quick examples because it's brand new and most people aren't familiar with this, don't know what it does. I've got my dashboard here. I've got a spot. I want to create a smart narrative that I want to have in here. If you're not seeing that, it is a new optional setting. So just go to options, go down to preview features, and turn on the new smart narrative visual. It will require a restart of Power BI. So it'll show up in two different forms. One is the new smart narrative little visual here. So I can click on that. When I click on that, it's just going to create a text box, and it's going to auto-populate from the data that's on my screen. It's going to provide some insights into what's going on inside here. The cool thing about this, though, is this is just a text box, so you can go in and you have all of your classical controls for your text box. You can go in. Pretty easy to use. The information is fairly intuitive and fairly intelligent. You can actually see it will underline where the AI is picking up different pieces of information and bringing it forward. There's some things you can do to train it. I'm not going to go into that inside this video, so I just want to give you a brief overview. But it basically just sees all the information that's on your screen and writes that narrative. When it writes the narrative, it is responsive in the same way that any visual in Power BI is. When you make a selection on it, everything slices and dices down to it. This is the basics of it. The other way you can go about creating the smart narrative is it is a pure function of the text box visual. So just by clicking on a text box, I can go and I can add in some text, and I can kind of put in some little like markers for where I want to include a value. And then I've got my little text box here. I just click on value. Click save. And now you can see that it auto-populates right into my text box. I can also control this by adding another one. And I've now created a little write-up and narrative where I can control everything that appears inside this window. This could be really useful if you're trying to create like a title, or you're trying to create some cards, or there's tons of different uses for this. It's a very powerful functionality that the Microsoft Power BI team has added into the solution. But I said I wanted to compare this against what's going on inside of Smart Narrative. So let's head over to that. We're going to test building on Narrative Science Visual at the same time, so we could test out the different functionalities that are available to that. So I've already downloaded and installed the new narratives for Power BI from Narrative Science. This is installed. So I'm going to go in and I'm going to add some measures to it. I'm going to add in a dimension so I can do a time series analysis. So you'll notice right off the bat, unlike the smart narratives from Power BI, Narrative Science doesn't just automatically self-generate the information for you. So it is looking for you to include some information inside your analysis. So I'm going to go run through and identify the information that I want to include. So I get to choose the measures that I want to include inside my narrative. And then I'm going to drag in the breakout that I want to do. So I want to do this by fiscal year. Now, Narrative Sciences will come along and it's going to ask us and kind of guide us through how we want to build out the narrative. So it'll give us a bunch of options as the different types of narrations we want to do. For the purposes of this demo, we're going to stick with continuous. So it goes in and writes a continuous narrative. As you can see, boom, it just pops up. And it's got a very rich narration has been created. I can go over to this cogwheel. I can click on it. I can choose how deep I want to go inside my narratives, how many different measures I want to drill into, or I can leave it the same. I get the to be able to year or years, which I get to describe, how do I want the this noun to be used when we're looking at this dimension. I can go into on each of the characteristics. I can describe qualities to it. So, these are, each of these values are numbers, or they're money, and they're good when they're high. This is a number, but it's good when it's high. Sales unit price, that's money, and it's good. All right. So, allows me to go in and make some customizations around that. I can go in and talk about different relationships. I can go and I could talk about the different analytics. I can start to get into some of the more data science-y aspects of this. And I can go to the display and I can say, I want good changes to be bold and green, and I want bad changes to be red and underlined bold as well. So this makes it very easy for me to go in and customize my solution. But let's look at these two side by side and do some little comparisons. Okay, when we look at these, it's kind of clear both of these visuals serve a different purpose. The Smart Narratives by Power BI, it provides you a brief little write-up of the information that's on your screen, or you can customize it. Customizations is a little more manual, but that's okay, right? Like, it gives you those capabilities. Narrative science, though, is clearly it is a more robust offering. I think one of the things that this blew me away when I saw this one this morning, because it calculated a CAGR. I don't know if you've ever tried to calculate a CAGR with DAX. It is not easy. it's one of those calculations that's a little kind of hard to create, but it does it quite well. So, what's the result? All right, it's clear we're kind of dealing with two different offerings. We've got Microsoft's Smart Narratives, right? And then we've got Narrative Sciences Narratives for Power BI. The question is, are we dealing with like a Pepsi and Coke type thing, where we're talking about two different, solutions that are kind of best in class, or not? And I think running through this demo, looking at this, we're not really dealing with Pepsi versus Coke. We're more of dealing with like Jolly Good Cola versus Coke. Right? Jolly Good is all well and good if it's a hot day and you're thirsty and you want some cola, you want a cola? Hey, great. Go for it, Jolly Good. That's fine. You'll definitely save some money. It's a great way to go. But if you're like many people in the world, if you really want a more mature, rich, good flavor, you go Coke, right? And I think the same thing is true that the Smart Narratives for Power BI. This is something that will meet your needs if you have some immediate needs to add in some narrations, add in some more text-based representation of your measures. It can really help you get started, but as you go and as you start to work with the tool, this is more of an MVP approach, I think, where you're going to find that there are things you're going to want to do when it comes to customizations and control that you're going to want to have, that it's a little difficult, or there's a lot of work that you have to do on the Power BI Smart Visuals side, where you just get that functionality out of the box with the Narrative Sciences visual. Frankly, I'm still going with the champ on this one. Narrative Sciences is clearly the more mature product, having been around for 10 years. And Power BI just being released, 2 weeks ago, Narrative Science still clearly, dominates, this space. We'll see what the next 10 years brings. It's entirely possible that 10 years from now, Power BI Smart Narratives will have really up the ante, and started to really compete with the narrative sciences visuals. So thank you guys very much for watching the video. As always, if you like the content, like, subscribe, turn on that little bell alarm so you get notified every time I publish content. And we will see you next time. Peace.